Hello children, I am here once again, and today's topic will be learning formation of noun under vocabulary development. Now the last time we were in class together, I taught you some things. Please, I would like you to go over and over the things I've taught you. If you have any question or any challenge, please try to contact me. My number is on the class platforms, so please call me so that we can discuss, and I will come to this to the next video and explain to you and explain to every other person who may not have the chance to have contacted me on the platform. So today's topic is a formation of noun from verb. This week we'll be looking at word formations. But before we start, let's look at our learning objective. In the class today, after this class rather, you should be able to learn how new words are created, identify affixes used to form nouns, use derived words constructively. I will repeat it again. Learn how new words are created, identify affixes used to form nouns, use derived word constructively. Note, the process of forming noun from verb and other parts of speech is called nominalization. Now, English language turns parts of speech from noun to adverb. So I will just simply mention them to you. Noun, verb, adjective, adverbs. They are expandable words. They are words that are not static in itself. What is a noun today could be a verb tomorrow. What is a verb tomorrow could be an adjective or an adverb. So they are expandable, they are not static. So another way also is that they could be formed into different word classes or word base or parts of speech by the addition or an adjustment of the words, of the root words. Now today in this lesson we'll be learning the formation of noun from verb. And there are lots of ways you can form noun from verbs, but for this lesson we shall be restricting ourselves to just two main method or ways of forming nouns from verb. But before then, let's look at an example of nominalization. The example below here, we have lactate. Lactate is a verb, but when you add a syllable or the syllable shun, it becomes lactation, lactation, and lactation is a noun. Lactation is a noun. So you see, at one point is a verb, lactate, and the next point, just a little adjustment, a little addition or infliction, it is now a noun. So you see, one thing is the context in which you are using these words. Sometimes the word doesn't even need to change their status or change or adjust their status or adjust their features before they are the other parts of speech, or they take another form or another word class. Sometimes they are just the way they are. So everything in English language and word usage is based on context, and context involves what you're using it for and the time in which you're using it and the place. So, and also context has to do with people. Yes, you would agree with me. I didn't want to go to that extent. You agree with me that sometimes children use verbs for noun and noun for verbs. For instance, the trendy one now, poo-poo. Poo-poo is a noun, but we make a verb out of poo-poo. So, and people who make verb out of poo-poo are children, little children. So you see, at one point a word could be a verb, and at the other point it will be a noun. Just the way we have on the screen, lactate, verb, then you add a little syllable or a syllable to it, it will give you a noun, lactation. Okay, here we have it's a diagram showing us the direction we would like to take on this topic. The first on the diagram is contraction. Contraction. Now it's trying to tell you contraction, we'll get there. Then beneath it we have suffixes, we have prefixes. On the left hand side we have the base words. On the right hand side we have the word order. Now when you have a base word is a root word, just the way we have lactate. Now that is the base word. Now when we add shin, which is the suffix to lactate, it will give us a new word order. Now addition simply means contraction. When you add the both of them to form just one word, it will give you a new word order. Then prefixes, these are ways in which we can also form or change or add to the meaning of a word. So let's go and look at them more explicitly. Now there are different ways where we form words or we derive words. One of such ways is affixation. Affixation entails three things. We have the infix, suffix, and prefix. That is affixation for you. But in today's topic, we'll only be looking at two aspects of affixation, that is the suffix and the prefix, and other ways of deriving words or forming new words. Now, but before then, let's see. Nouns are derived using suffixes and prefixes. Suffixes are syllables added at the end of a root word. Suffixes are syllables added at the end of a root word. At the end of a root word. Prefixes are syllables added at the beginning of a root word. Prefixes are syllables added at the beginning of a root word. Now, other ways which we can form words, we have acronym, loan and borrowing, clipping, back formation. These are other ways we can also form words. There are more of it. We have conversion. There are more of it, but we shall discuss it later. Suffixes that form noun. Suffixes that form noun. Like I said earlier, the suffixes are syllables. Syllables that are added at the end of a root word. At the end of a root word. So let's see these examples below. Examples of suffixes. Syllables are not words. They are just a puny unit of words that can add or change the actual meaning of the entire word. So these are syllables we have on the screen. We shall be looking at them now. We have age, all, ounce, asian, ence, shin, meant, shin, sis, shin. These are syllables, and these syllables are suffixes. They are added at the end of a root word, just the way we have lactate and we have what, lactation. The shin there is a suffix, is a syllable that has been added to the root word lactate, and it gives us a word class, a different word class other than what it was known to be before, which is lactate. Now the word class given to us is lactation. So you see the change. more of suffixes. We have other suffixes for referring to people, and there are some on the screen, and some I will also mention on my own. So please, I would advise as you listen to this slide, please have your pen and paper with you, because there are some points I'll be raising on the slide which you may not see on the screen. So it's very, very important that you take note and see what and listen to what I have to say. So the noun or the syllables for suffixes that refers to human, that when you add them to the verb, it will automatically become a noun. These are them. Let's call them out. We have the er. When you add er plus write, it will give you writer, and a writer is a noun. Then write is a verb. Then you add er to teach, which is a verb. Then when you add the er, it gives you teacher. Teacher is a noun. Then sale is a verb. When you add or, it gives you seller, which is a noun. Then beg is a verb. Then when you add the ar to it, it gives you beggar. And we also have another one. We have ant, ant. And we have words like context. But when you add ant to it, it gives you what? Contestant. Then the next one is study. When you add ent and remove the y, it gives you student, and student is a noun. Then the other one we have train. You add ee, it gives you trainee. So we also have some beneath. These ones beneath could be noun, and they can also be an adjective. So you see, we have Republican, we have Liberian. Then on beneath it, we have a tourist. Now there's something about tourist, or let's say tour. Tour could be a noun, it could be a verb, and it can also be an adjective. So here we have tourist. Tourist is a noun, because we have this the suffix for for referring to human being at the end of the word. Tor is a root word, then the IST is the syllable. So you can see from the screen that some of the syllables are written in red, while the others are written in black. So, but those ones that are written in black, and even the ones written in a red pen, red ink, you will notice, or red color, sorry, you will notice that the syllables are already separated to show you that they are added to this word to form another word class. So all these are nouns that have been formed using the syllables you see on the screen. More of such, we have shin. Shin. Now on the shin, we have restriction, which when you remove the ion, which is a syllable, it will no longer become restriction, it will be restrict. And restrict is a verb, but when you add the ion, it gives you restriction. As well as contribute, you add ion, it gives you contribution, reaction, prediction, protection. So the addition of the syllable or the suffix ion automatically changed the word class from verb to noun. So on the screen here, all this, the five examples you can see on the screen, they are noun. Now let's talk about prefaces. Prefaces that form nouns. Now, there is something I really want you to take note of. Suffixes Yes, they change the meaning of a word. They add more meaning to a word, and they derive words. Suffixes basically derive word. That means suffixes basically brings out new words. Now, the power of prefixes to derive word is not as much as that of suffix. What basically prefixes does is to add or change the meaning of a word, but suffixes derive word and also add to the meaning or change the meaning of a word. But suffixes derive word more than prefixes. So when you look at our past parts of speech and also look at our past tense, you find that basically we add suffixes to it. And when you add suffixes to it, you find that it's showing you tenses. So suffixes performs a whole lot of job in English language. Yes, because I can say in all honesty that suffixes is the most frequently used in English language. Check out our numbers in English, singular and plural. Yes, for you to show the plural of a word, you need to add s at the end of that word. The s you added, or the syllable s you added, is suffix. So suffixes does a whole lot of things. Now, prefixes are words, as I said earlier, they add to the meaning of a word and they change the meaning of a word. They add and they change, and they are added at the beginning of such word. Now, example of prefix. Yes, let's see. We have possible and impossible. Now, adding prefix in to possible does not change the word class of possible. It just changed the meaning, or added to the meaning of that word. It just added to the meaning of that word. Possible, impossible. Possible is positive. Then impossible is negative, telling you not possible. So that is what it does. So let's look at the syllables that you add to a noun, and it will give you you add to a verb, it will give you a noun using prefix. Now, we have sub, an, mal, over, pre, de, miss, ex, utter, inter, miss. Again, so these are prefixes that when you add them to a root word, at the beginning of a root word, it will automatically give us a noun. But let's see some of the examples we have here. We have a prefix, we have words. And the first on our example is this. Now, when you add this, which is a prefix, to appear, which is a noun, a verb, when you add it, you add this to it, this is the prefix, and you add ence, which is a suffix, this will give us what? It will give us a noun. We have the word disappearance in noun. Then when you add none to smoke, which can be a noun, a verb, and even an adjective. But when you add none to it and you add a little suffix to it, it will give you non-smoker. The none is the prefix. Then the er or r is the suffix. So we have an automatic noun here, non-smoker. Then we have the mal, malfunction, maltreatment. You see the prefix and the suffix, because when you look at this word maltreatment, you find that is three syllables or three words there. Let me put it that way. We have the mal, we have the treat and ment. Now the two, the one at the front and the one behind, is what? Is the prefix and the suffix. Then the middle one is the base word. So you see, when you add these things, it gives you what? It gives you a new word, and that word is noun. So we got maltreatment from treat, which is a verb. Look at over, overflow. You just add the over to the overflow. It will give you what? It will give you a different word altogether, which overflow could be a noun or even an adjective. So, but in this aspect, we're using it as a noun. Then we have auto, auto charge, auto charge. You see, auto charge is a noun. It could also be an adjective, just the way I said adjective, noun, verb, and adverb. They are expandable words. They are words that could change today from what you used to know them for, and what to what you don't know, or to an entirely new word order. Now we have the pre. When you add it to fix, the pre is a syllable, then the fix is the verb. But when you add the pre to the fix, it gives you a noun, and that is the name of a concept, so it's a noun. So what am I trying to say? All these prefixes, syllables, they have their own meaning, but they are puny, or the tiny aspect of a word. They have their own meaning, because this, noun, mal, over, auto, pre, they have meanings. So when they add this meaning to the word, it expands or changes the word class of that particular word. So these are prefixes used to form noun. Let's go, let's look at more examples. We have sub, subdivision, on, unrest, this, ablement, degeneration, mistake. All these words, when you remove the prefix, division can still stand as a noun. But when you add de to it, it will give you divide, and divide is a verb. So, adding the sub and the shin makes it a noun. We have rest. Adding the on to the rest makes it a noun, and the rest can also be a verb, an adjective. So we have this ablement. Able is the root word there. We just added the this and the ment, and it gives us a noun. Now we have degenerate is a verb. But because we added the D and the I-O-N, it gives us a noun. Then we have mistake. Now let's look at them in sentence form. Let's see how they are used. Maybe that would help us understand better. She is under protection. Protection is a noun. Now, I know that some of you will look at this sentence and I say, without writing the noun, let's assume there is no noun in bracket or verb in bracket. And I say, where is the noun in this sentence? I'm sure some of you would go and underline the shin and the protection, which is very, very wrong. Protection is a noun and not a verb. Here is the noun aspect of it. She is under protection now, so she's protected. Verb. Did you see the difference? Under protection, so she's protected. So one is passive, the other one is active. So you see? All right. The fair lady duplicated the form. So it was a duplication, not original. You see, a duplication is a noun. Duplicated is a verb. Lucas was invited. Invited is a noun. Is a verb, sorry. Invited is a verb. Lucas was invited to the party. Invited is a verb. He received an invitation. Invitation is a noun. The new driver added the R to the drive, gives us driver, and drive is a verb. Now when you add the R or the syllable to it, it gives you driver. And driver, the ER is one of the syllables for referring to people. So the driver is a noun, then drives, verb. The new driver drives better than the previous one. You see the way I used it in the sentence? You could see the difference. One, the new driver. The driver is referring to somebody, and we're told that a noun is a name of a person, animal, animal, place, and things, an idea. You see? So, driver is a noun referring to somebody. Now, the other sentence is drunkard. The drunkard talks loudly. Talks is a verb. I think he is a talkative. Talkative is a noun. So you see, we also have active. Active as a syllable. Now let's see. And the syllable it is surface. Now let's see more. They have a big decision to make. We can't decide for them. Decision is a noun, decide is a verb. Did you see the difference? He explained. Explained is a verb. Everything to me, but his explanation is a noun, was unbelievable. The actor never takes criticism. This ISM is another syllable for referring to noun. The actor never takes criticism, noun, although he criticizes, verb. Is criticizes, verb. So he criticizes others. The last here is the boy who wore the jumper. Jumper is a noun. Jumped the fence. You could see the thing there is when you read out the noun and the verb, you could sense the difference. One is passive, the other one is active. I'll just like you to free yourself and read it up by yourself, and you'll find out that one is active, the other one is passive. And you could see the prefixes and the suffixes added to them, and the prefixes. So when you see these things, you know that yes, like the example I gave to you, those examples of suffixes I gave were suffixes that basically we use them to form noun. So please, I would like you to take note of these suffixes and also the prefixes, so that when words are given to you, you should know how to form them. Though there are other words that they change their word class without actually changing anything or adding anything to them. It just depends on how they are used. Just like I said earlier, that English words, noun, verb, adjective, and adverb are expandable. Today, they can be noun. Today, tomorrow, a noun can be a verb, and like that. The list and the change goes on and on and on. So, please, I need you to look at this slide again. Take note of what you've heard and what you have seen. And also know that there are some words that don't need prefixes or suffixes to be a noun or a verb. But these are basically the ways we use to form words, especially verb from noun or noun from verbs. Now, having said all that I've said, I just need you to attempt this puny or this little task. Not very much though, it's just a few tasks for you to do. All I need you to do here is to form noun from these verbs. All that are listed are verbs. We have obstruct, admire, add, consider, agree, whitening. Oh my, some people will say whitening. I thought it's color. Whitening is not color. Whitening is not color. The end there has changed it entirely. It's not color. It's a verb. It's a verb. The act of making something white is whitening. So, since it's whitening, I need you to change it to verb, to a noun. So these are all I have for you today on prefix and suffix. So when you are changing, I would like you to use either prefix or suffix for them, as the case may be. Having said all this, I want to wish you happy, stay at home, be good, try as much as you can to submit your tax promptly, and don't fight. Stay safe. Have a lovely day. Thank you.